rest in peace, Robopi. Hey everyone, Templar74 here with another Yu-Gi-Oh video, and today's Yu-Gi-Oh video is going to be my thoughts and impressions regarding the latest episode of Yu-Gi-Oh VRAINS, episode 114, Dreaming Robopi. And I gotta be honest with you guys, although the outcome of this duel was pretty much known before going into it, this episode was still really well done in my opinion. There were some really impactful moments, especially towards the end there, and overall, I really enjoyed the episode, but we'll talk about all of that soon enough. So, at risk of further rambling, let's move on to the actual episode. So the episode begins with a recap of last week's episode before moving on to Soul Burner. And Soul Burner at this point really has to pull out all the stops. He really has to make a big comeback here because otherwise Robopi's going to win the duel. And Soul Burner does not disappoint. He manages to rebuild his entire field and mounts another attack with Salamon Great Claw and Heat Lyo combination. Of course, he managed to get Claw back from the graveyard and resurrect Heat Lyo. And if these three attacks get through, thanks to Salamon Great Claw, he's going to win the duel. However, Robopi is not yet to be underestimated and not yet about to lose this duel. Robopi uses Electrical World's effect to move Laundry Dragon to be co-linked with Cell Tops. And with that, Heat Lyo is destroyed. However, it's at this point Soul Burner brings out another surprise here, something he's able to pull out another stop. He's able to bring out a new rank 4 Xyz monster, Salamon Great Blaze Dragon. And he's able to do this with two monsters that he sent to the graveyard, one of them being Zebroid X. And what this monster does, and this is important, is its effect allows Blaze Dragon to gain 600 attack points, 300 attack points for each of its overlay units here. So now we've got a powered up Blaze Dragon who's moving in for an attack. Soul Burner's still not done as he uses the quick play spell Salamon Great Tail, and what it does is it powers up Blaze Dragon to 4100 attack points and restores Soul Burner's life points up to 2000. What this does is it basically takes the defense points of Salamon Great Blaze Dragon and adds it to its attack, and of course Soul Burner regains that amount in life points. So Soul Burner's really pulled out all the stops here. Blaze Dragon moves in for the attack, and as he attacks, we see something strange happen to Robopi. Berserker Robopi shows up at this point. I call it Berserker Robopi because the first thing that popped into my mind when I saw this was Yuya back in Arc 5 when he went Berserk for the first time there in Episode 40. That's really what this reminded me of. He's a completely different Robopi now, and he is ruthless. This even shocks I at how ruthless Robopi has become, and we learn a little bit later on why this is. So anyway, we'll talk about that soon enough. So anyway, Berserker Robopi. Berserker Robopi manages to destroy Blaze Dragon and corner Soul Burner again, but before he finishes him off, he ends his turn because we see Berserker Robopi here kind of malfunction, and we see Berserker Robopi revert back into normal Robopi, and we learn that this is all because Robopi can't handle Eye's program. Because these two became one during the Bowman arc here, when I gave Robopi his backup program, we learn that Robopi, being just a cleaning AI, can't handle the Ignis program of I, and of course malfunctions, reverts back into regular Robopi. And as regular Robopi at this point is now lying on the ground, Robopi's going back to this, I must clean the master's room, that's when I'm my happiest. And it's at this point we get a very rare emotional moment from none other than Playmaker. Playmaker looks on down at Robopi, who's now on his stomach, just trying to get back up, wanting to go back to cleaning his room, and Robopi saying that that was the happiest time of its life when it was cleaning its master's room. And Playmaker just kind of looks at this, and we get a long, somber moment. We get a nice flashback between Yusaku and Robopi here, because at this point it's Yusaku in the real world. We get a nice little moment between these two, but ultimately Playmaker makes the right call. He tells Soul Burner, end Robopi, end the duel. You know, you gotta finish it off. And so Soul Burner does. He finishes off Robopi by reviving Blaze Dragon, and he destroys Robopi in a mountain of flame. Robopi's destroyed, and with Robopi destroyed, we end up getting a clue as to where I was. It's this little purple envelope thing, and we also learn that this clue is what I gave Robopi way back before the duel began. And as Robopi's destroyed, of course, we go back to I, who's now heartbroken at the loss of Robopi, saying Robopi was a good guy, I'm sorry. And we see the Lingaribo spaceship thing kind of turn around, do a sad, somber trail off to this satellite here, and that's where the episode leaves off. So yeah, this episode was a really good episode. Like I said, although the episode outcome was known, we knew that Soulburner was going to win the duel when these last batch of summaries and titles came out. We knew Soulburner was going to win. The way they handled this duel and the way they handled it, especially there at the end with Berserker Robopi reverting back to normal, and you kind of feel sad for Robopi here, because Robopi just kind of got sucked into this, not of its own free will, and Playmaker ultimately having to make the choice of having to destroy his friend here, even though it's now back to being the harmless little Robopi that we all knew from beginning of series here. It was really an impactful moment to even see Playmaker have some emotion here for an AI that's been part of the show since the very beginning. It was all very touching here. Soulburner's comeback was just incredible. The new cheese monster was a little bit unexpected for me, not gonna lie, but yeah, overall this was a very well-rounded episode, and I'm glad Soulburner redeemed himself after his loss to Bowman. Overall, I give this episode an 8.5 out of 10. It was a really good episode. It was good animation. We had some good moments here. Again, the only thing that sets these episodes back for me is the outcome was already known. If the outcome was not known to me, I would have loved this episode even more, and I think that's kind of my own fault because I kind of get suckered into reading the summaries here. I really got to stop doing that, but like I said, if I had known what the outcome of this episode was going to be, this episode would have ranked higher, and it would have even gotten a 9.5, maybe even a 10 out of 10. Like I said, it's kind of my own little blunder here that this episode got knocked down a little bit, but as always, in the comment section down below, let me know what you guys thought about this week's episode. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Did you think it was just there? What were your thoughts? What were your thoughts on Playmaker making the decision to end his friend? Just let me know what your guys' thoughts are about all this in the comment section down below, because as always, I enjoy hearing from you. All right, everyone. As always, Templar74 signing off. Have a great day, everybody, and I'll talk to you all next time. Goodbye, everybody.